Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to my Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim franchise mode series. It still feels so weird saying that. Just call them the Anaheim Angels, please. Anyway, we had a very exciting episode the last time out. We had a 22-inning ball game, a marathon extra inning game going more than two-plus ball games worth. We also had a perfect game by Garrett Richards that we jumped into. Starting in the seventh inning, we finished it off, guided it all the way through to the perfect game. But now we're taking on the New York Mets at Citi Field in interleague play, and we'll be going against Matt Harvey. Now, in real life, Matt Harvey ran into some trouble last night with his arm. Was not throwing his fastball up to his standard. Sounds like he'll be going on the DL, but in this version of things, he is dominant. He's got an under one ERA, somehow only 3-1 in those eight starts with that ERA. That's almost criminal right there, but let's see what we can get done against him. Maybe knock that above one with the likes of Mike Trout in the lineup. Let's see Trout's first at bat in the first inning, and he hits it hard, but unfortunately, it's going to be caught out in center field. Deserved to hit the way he hit it, but that's not what is going to happen. So we're sending Jesse Chavez to the mound, who has also done quite well for himself. Not Matt Harvey numbers by any means, but he's pitching well, and we'll see if that continues today. Breaking ball right there for strike three swinging, and he is through the first inning, only allowing a walk. We take this now to the third inning, where a fly ball out to Mike Trout in center field should be a routine play, and it is, ending the inning. So Chavez matching Matt Harvey every step of the way so far, and is actually not even allowed a hit to this point. So don't get too excited. I don't know if we're going to be talking perfect game again today. As a matter of fact, that is impossible because he's already allowed a walk in the first inning. No hitter, maybe? Yeah. Again, way ahead of ourselves. Matt Harvey, again, retires this Angels lineup. And we are dancing in the stands. First time I've seen this animation. I've seen some dancing, but not the whole section like this. Well, hold on a second. I take that back. There was the animation from Oakland where they do their crazy dance as well. So they fit those in once in a while. Kind of cool to see something you haven't seen. I suppose if you play with the Mets all the time, maybe you did. This ball is deep to right, and, well, the no-hitter's gone, and so is the shutout. That is a solo shot for Curtis Granderson, and the Mets take the 1-0 lead. Six home runs now for Granderson, and the home crowd wakes up a little bit here. That might be the only thing that Harvey needs. Now, what do those numbers mean on that sign? Is that some kind of inside thing I should be able to try to decipher? I was trying to figure out what that's all about. I know they put little nods to some of the people in the community before on the signs. Maybe that's an inside thing right there. I was trying to figure out what the heck. I mean, they look like coordinates or something like that. Anyway, maybe somebody has an answer to that for me in the comment section. If not, enjoy Curtis Granderson's home run one more time, as it is now 1-0 in favor of the Mets. Like I said, we got to try to scratch through against Harvey now. That is going to be a hit, or is it? Great play out and left by Yoenis Cespedes as he robs Escobar of at least a base hit, maybe an extra base hit, but he comes on diving and making the catch. Beautiful play out there in left field. The very next batter is Cole Calhoun, and we've talked about his struggles so far this season, but this one is deep and gone. A line drive home run shot, solo shot, tying the ball game. So it's too bad. With the big web jam by Cespedes out and left, this could have been a two-run homer and put us ahead. We'll settle for the 1-1 score and Cole Calhoun's fifth of the season. Very timely home run as we are just trying to scratch anything across the board against Matt Harvey. Well, there you go. We are on the board now, and it's a brand new baseball game. So what can we do from here on out? We fast forward to the eighth inning, and both starting pitchers, despite doing so well, have both been pinch hit for, trying to get that leg up. This is Jordan Walden in the game, and that ball's hit a long way, but it is caught by Mike Trout in the warning track. So we get out of the inning. Jordan Walden has been lights out since getting him as a free agent, and funny enough, I looked up his stats. Actually pitched for the Angels from 2010 to 2012. Well, we got him back here, and he's doing a great job for us. This is going to be a ground ball to third base, and that is Albert Pujols getting thrown out as we are going to the bottom of the ninth inning. Walden still in the game, and he's going to get a pop-up here. Should be an out. Pujols playing first base, and maybe that's not a good thing because he drops this easy pop-up. And, well, we just let the runner on that could be the potential game-winning run. What's going on? I know some of you have said in the comments before, what is Pujols doing playing first base? But in a National League park, we need his bat, and we don't have the designated hitter. So, there you go. Walden is able to clean up the mess. And once again, he is pitching great for us out of the bullpen. What a acquisition that was, just picking him up off the free agent wire. And he is fired up here to keep this game at 1-1. We now fast forward to the bottom of the 10th inning, and Yoenis Cespedes gets strike two on him, so two outs and two strikes. Let's get out of another inning, and that's not the case. Deep and gone. It's going to be a walk-off homer for the Mets, and Yoenis Cespedes, he sends everyone home happy at Citi Field. Well, everyone except Mike Socha and the Angels lineup, that is. Cespedes goes deep, and his teammates are waiting at home plate. Matt Harvey, one of those right there, you see him slapping home plate. Says, come on, let's celebrate this walk-off in style. Throws away the batting helmet. Mets win the game in dramatic extra inning walk-off fashion. So that's a tough one for the Angels to swallow right there, as they are not able to get it done. Look at the replay of the nice swing here, sending everybody home and ending this ball game. Yoenis Cespedes, he has come through again. And the Mets win the ball game. So we get a little interview with him after the game. Here is your player of the game. A little ribbing from his teammates. But it's a 2-1 final in 10 innings. The pitcher's duel does not come down to a decision for either starter. We lose 2 of 3 in the Mets series. And then it's on to Tampa Bay, where we lose a couple games. Win the third game in the series, and now a chance to close out a save, and strike three, Bedrosian gets it done. So we're going to go ahead and split this series in Tampa, mostly simming, obviously, but playing the critical situations. Go ahead and dab in honor of this road victory. 5-4 is your final. Just a quick in and out right there, getting the critical situation taken care of in form of the save. So now, after splitting that series, it'll be more interleague play. In Miami, we lose the first game of the series. Second game, we're going to jump in here and we're going to go ahead and quick manage. I like to do that once in a while, see if we can steer our club towards a victory by pulling the right strings here, managing. Although a lot of what's happening here is kind of out of my control. We bunt players over a little bit once in a while, but these home runs, that's all on the players. As right now, we've got the 4-3 lead. Let's make it 6-3. Should finish off a victory. Yep, the Angels do win it 6-3. I always quick manage those games with the hope of, if it's really close down the stretch, I will jump in and try to play the final outcome. But here we got a critical situation against Atlanta, and it looks like we are trying to once again close down a game. Up 3-2. And it's going to be a hit up the middle. Trout is going to come up throwing here. They're going for it at the plate to tie the game. He's out at the plate. Trout guns him down and the game is over. The Angels, not as smooth as it would have liked it, but Trout saves the day right there, throwing out the runner, trying to score the tying run. Angels win 3-2. Atlanta got that hit they were looking for. They just could not get the run across the plate to tie the game. So we win game one of the series, and we're right back into another critical situation. This time we're down, and we got to try to rally. Cole Calhoun coming to the plate, 0-3. We saw a home run in New York earlier from him in this episode, but still, batting average-wise and overall in the season, it's been a struggle. So we're down 2-1 with a runner in scoring position. It is up the middle. Play is made. Can he throw him out? And ball game, no safe. Runner coming around third and scores all the way from second base. Is that Ben Revere showing the wheels there? Yes. Tie game on an infield single of all things. Yeah, he had to range towards the outfield to make this play behind the second base bag. Yeah, he's on the outfield grass. Strong throw, but not in time. And then Revere never stops, coming around to score that run. We go to the 15th inning. We like marathon games around here. That's going to be a strikeout. And that's Jordan Walden again doing work in extra innings. So I meant to kind of just set the table here and then play the moments. Well, we get a walk-off home run while I'm quick managing. So that's how the ball game is going to end. I kind of figured if anyone got in scoring position, I would play it. This is what I did with innings previous to that. This time, no need to, as the walk-off home run ends the game. So we not only rally, we take the win, and can we do it again? Another chance here. Down a run. You got Mike Trout at the plate. You got a runner on first base, and you got two outs. So once again, we're going to try to be the comeback kids and see what we can do. Can Trout maybe hit a walk-off home run here? Send everyone home? Oh, man, they're going to hit him. That pitch gets away, and he hits him. I don't think he meant to do that because you're putting the winning run potentially on base now, and that's not good strategy. So I'm just going to assume that got away from him. Trout's got to shake it off, but now you got Albert Pujols coming to the plate, who recently hit his 600th home run. Congrats to Albert Pujols for doing that in real life. I'm not sure how many off we are in video game form here. Hopefully this season we will hit 600 with him as well. That's through, and it could tie the game. It does. So once again, a ninth inning rally. This time Albert Pujols with the base hit up the middle, and we're tied 5-5. But hold up a second, because the winning run now standing 90 feet away with a chance to walk this off. But first, you're going to see a couple replays of Pujols' swing. So can we bring that run home? CJ Cron, he's going to strike out. So nope, we are going to go to extra innings, but at least we extended this ball game. We jump forward to the bottom of the 11th. Now Mike Trout's next at bat. He got hit in the ninth inning, but now in the 11th, hoping to get on base and set the table, and he will do just that. A solid single to center field, and Mike Trout is on first base. Now remember, he's got some pretty good wheels. He's an 86 speed, so something in the gap could end this ball game. Let's take a look at his cut a couple times here as he is able to get on base in the bottom of the 11th. Well, this will bring you-know-who up, Albert Pujols. Hopefully he can get another base knock here and really put the pressure on the Atlanta Braves. So here comes the pitch, and oh my goodness, he's done better than hit a single. That is deep and gone. This time it's the Angels walking it off. Albert Pujols does it in style. Extra inning, two-run shot. Angels win 7-5. Oh, that one feels good. We let one slip away in that same fashion in New York while we take one here from Atlanta with the walk-off. Albert Pujols, you get to celebrate a big home run right here. We'll have to check how many he is away from 600. And actually, while commentating this, I actually fired the game up again to look. That was home run number 600 for Albert Pujols. We got robbed of a graphic on it because it was a walk-off game winner, and it triggered that celebration. But otherwise, we would have seen that that was number 600 for Albert Pujols on the career exactly. And man, I know he did it grand slam in real life, and it was dramatic. But can you imagine if you would have been a walk-off for number 600 like we just did right here? That's really too bad. I was kind of hoping for the whole animation to play out and the celebration on screen of 600 home runs. We're not going to get that, but just know that was number 600 for Albert Pujols, and it comes in a huge spot for the Angels, securing the victory. So once again, come from behind and then win it in extra innings in style. So when we come back, we have hit the Major League Baseball draft. That just happened in real life the other day as well, catching up to real life events on the calendar. So we've got the draft next time. Will we have a successful draft to build for the future? Come on back next time to find out.